Hello, everyone.
Hello, Jiri. First of all, welcome back. And to fighting, I mean, it's been a while out of there, so how excited are you, not just for this fight, but to be fighting at all?
It's an honor to be here, especially in New York, Madison Square Garden, like a main event. It's an honor for me, especially after a long, tough year. And I believe this fight will be great. And I believe in my winner.
You're a man who's very famous for taking on the energy of occasions. What exactly is the energy for this week? Madison Square Garden main event against a guy like Alex for the world title after so long away. What is the energy for you this week, and how exactly are you feeling within yourself before this fight?
For me, this week, laser focus. For me, it's about the laser focus for the performance in the night, in the event night. And it's not just about me, but it's just about my opponent too. Because which performance, how good the performance of my opponent will be, that good will be mine. Because I'm every time adjust, and I am better every time than my opponents, trying to be in every moment. Yeah, so I like to have a good opponents, because opponents' performance push my performance.
There's been some talk from the fans that this is the samurai versus the indigenous tribesman. Do you see it that way, and do you see this as a warrior versus warrior kind of fight?
I see it like warrior against the warrior, yeah, like you said. I don't want to speak about my samurai character or something like that, but it's true, it's truth. Because I was inspired many years by these codex Bushido and this type of focus for a fight, for everything what you're doing in your life, to do it with all your focus, give all your heart to your performance. So that's why we are the warriors. Yeah, because we go there and there is nothing left. Yeah.
Alex is one of the greatest strikers of all time, you know, Hall of Famer in kickboxing. But do you believe he's ever seen a man who strikes in the way that you do?
Yeah, because I'm every time trying to find a way where my opponent will be not expect that. That's the key to win, because it's about to win in the way that your opponent don't expect that. So you have to see. I don't see somebody like his. I'm not watching his techniques. Yeah, and I'm watching his weak points, and there I will attack with the full power. That's why it's my style a little bit risky, but it's a part of myself. I need to go there with everything, but I little upgrade my style, because Alex is a like top level stand-up guy, so I'm prepared for that.
The last time we saw you, it was one of the greatest fights of all time. Do you think this Saturday it'll be a similar fight where you'll show your warrior spirit, or do you plan on learning from that performance against Glover and coming in better and showing that you are the best in the world and make it not a war but a great performance instead?
Both of that, yeah, too, because there is no different between like to learn something from the past and still show the best. Yeah, so I learned from that fight with Glover a lot. Really, it gave me a lot. And now I want to prove that.
Jiri, right here. Last year at this card, you were supposed to fight Glover later on before your injury. And then, obviously, Jamahal won. And then there were talks that you would fight Jamahal. And now you're fighting Alex. And it seems fans are more excited for your fight against Alex than your possible fights against Jamahal or the rematch against Glover. I'm curious if you feel that, and what do you make of your two styles that fans are... This is the fight that they have circled.
I didn't thought about the Jamahal or Pereira, who's the better. But if I can say it now, I think the Pereira styles in stand-up is a much sharper than Jamahal Hill style. Yeah, that's my opinion. And yeah.
Jiri, just over here. Was it hard to sit out on the sidelines, obviously having to relinquish the title? Did it make you more determined to get the title back? What was it like seeing how the division changed?
I just respect the everything have to goes on, yeah, and I realized that I'm not afraid that when I put the belt out like to other guys that I will not win that again after my recovery, full recovery. So that's my belief that I will take the belt again. And that's it.
And how was the recovery?
Great.
Did you learn anything about yourself in your time away?
Sure. It's about the life is about the learning to push your limits, attack them, be better, and that's all about. So all that year was for me the big challenge, like every day. Yeah, and yeah, I really enjoyed that. Sometimes it was really tough, but that's life.
And I saw that you went to Iceland and trained with Gunnar Nelson. What was that experience like?
Gunnar Nelson is a true master in his field, because we spoke. I just wanted to know his mindset, how he's working, how he using the body in the wrestling situation, because he's the master of the ground game, yeah, and he have nice movements too in the stand up, so that's what we work on. Mainly, I was on Iceland because to see the nature, to take a power from nature, and with my sponsor, Life Cycle. Yeah.
And do you still view the belt as yours? And how much would it mean to you to get it back and to continue where you left off?
The belt from last year I have on my room. And I'm still seeing myself like a champion, but I need to. I need to remind to the all people that I really am, because I need to keep it in the present.
And you and Alex both won titles in the same year. Did you ever view him as someone that could be a potential opponent?
Like when?
Did you ever, you know, see him and think that perhaps you could fight him somewhere down the line? When he captured his title?
when he captured his title, like where? Like title of
did you know
middleweight?
Yeah.
I didn't thought about Alex like opponent before he started to speak, like about to move up, way up, way to move up the weight class, and after that I saw him like yes, this guy is really good, he can be my opponent. Especially how when he saw me in last July in Vegas, and after our fight in with Glover, I was there for that fight week, and I saw him and he was like still watched me like some enemy, and after that I said myself like yeah, this was extraordinary, and can be maybe in the future it can be my opponent.
Thank you.
Hey, Jiri, back here. Is the plan here with a win to wait until Hill is healthy to fight, or is that too long? Do you want to fight again before that?
Doesn't matter for me right now. I'm not thinking about other opponents right now. Is the Alex Pereira here, and after I believe in my win, I will face whoever will be there, the best. For me, it doesn't matter who it will be. I just want to see the challenge before me, somebody who I see like he's the dangerous.
And then just one more from me. Obviously, Hill is going through something somewhat similar to what you went through in terms of recovery and vacating the belt. Do you have any like words of advice for him, or just any words at all? Like, what would you tell him in this moment?
Take the time because our body is our weapon, and so we need to take care about that. Yeah, to get full power, it's necessary to have a time for that, to use all the things.
Erko, just one question for me. After such a massive acceptance from the Czech fans, after your win over Glover, are you considering pushing UFC to arrange another event in Czech Republic, which you would headline?
Poland, yeah.
Czech Republic.
You are from Poland.
Brno.
Yeah, but you are from Poland, yeah.
Kámo, trénoval jsme spolu.
Aha. Co si říkal? Yeah, sure. It will be the it will be a great opportunity to show that in Czech Republic and in the Europe there is a lot of fans which likes to watch MMA, because and we need it in Europe. We are a little bit like there is a lot of now in this age there is a lot of pussymans. How to say it on the good way? I need to say that like that because it's right. So we need to watch the fights, watch the rare power of a man against another man to be full in our life. Yeah, so not just for that, but we like the fights in Czech Republic and in the Europe.
Thank you. We just see.
Jeden proto.
And on a more lighthearted note, it's nice to see the top knot back after the short haircut from previous fights. What made you decide to grow back the hair?
The reason is I didn't end one of my chapter. One of my chapter in my life, and I can't do something, especially the fighting, without my how I'm seeing myself in the mirror, and this haircut, my war hair, is made it especially for this moment, for the fight week, for the fight, and it gave me the power to see myself how I want to see myself all the time, to be connected with my most beautiful ideas about my style, about my ancestors, about the power which gave me. And I can't explain, and I don't want to speak about it more because it's too personal.
Jiri in the back left. How are you feeling physically? How was this training camp, and how do you compare to before the injury?
I feel great, prepared, everything is settled. So training camp, most of the time in camp, I was in Czech Republic, but I have really good coaches around me, and they helped me to improve my style, to be more complex fighter, to not just find a way just in a stand up in the right moments, but on the ground too, in the wrestling too. And that's the one of the best thing what I really happy for, that I see all my weapons, all my body to that can work in every part, stand up, wrestling, ground game. For me, it doesn't matter now.
And where do you see an advantage in this matchup? I know you're confident wherever it goes, but, and you also talked about aiming at weaknesses in your opponents. What weaknesses are you going to try and exploit out of Pereira?
Next question, please.
You just opened a store, your very own store in the Czech Republic. Just what did that mean to you, and how excited are you for that?
That's the thing, yeah. My store, my brand, which working from year 2015, it's not just the brand with the clothes. It's a brand with idea, with the life stand, yeah. And I want to share this life stand, this attitude, with the people, with other people who feel the same, to go simply, to do everything with full power. Yeah, to use our potential in our life in a full line. Yeah.
Right here also. You've leaned on the philosophy of Bushido a lot, specifically Musashi's five rings, the concept of never being too high, too low. You're in the most chaotic city in probably the world. You're fighting at MSG, which is, the stakes are always super high for a combat athlete. Your philosophy, where is it right now in this environment? Can you just describe the atmosphere and how your philosophy of Bushido has helped you kind of manage mentally where you are in this atmosphere?
I can answer only the same sentences like I said many times, because it's all the time the same. And the key is in the life, the consistency. Yeah, to keep consistent your stand, keep your discipline, keep your attacking for your challenges. Challenges in your mind, challenges in your body, with your body. Search for the deep soul connection, spirit connection, and make it stronger in all the line. Yeah. So that's the way which helped me my philosophy with that, and especially on the place like here in the Madison, like New York, Madison Square Garden, really big event. And I want to share that by that fight with other people, that it's possible to be full power warrior who's connected with these ideas. That's what I like.
Thanks.
Thank you, everybody. See you on Saturday.